I left Oklahoma in 1925 and went to Oroville. That's where that them three girls, his dad died, was in Oroville, 1931. And I was 28 years old, and I had five kids, and that one was on the road. She never even saw her daddy. She was born after he died.
Very hard.
And cheap.
And cheap. I picked cotton in Fireball when that girl there was about 2 years old. I picked cotton in Fireball for 50 cents a hundred.
A hundred weight?
100 pounds.
How much did you pick in a day then?
I generally picked around 450, 500. Mm-hmm. I didn't even weigh 100 pounds. I lived down there in Shafton. I'd be home before daylight and come in after dark. Just existed. You know, we any way we lived, we survived. Let's put it that way. I walked from what they call a Hoover campground right there at the bridge. I walked from there to way down on First Street and worked at a penny a dish down there for 50 cents a day and the leftovers. You know, they gave me what was left over to take home with me. Sometimes I'd carry home two water buckets full. Well, we started from L.A. to Watsonville.
Mm-hmm.
And the timing chain broke on my car, and I had a guy to pull in his pecan in La Poma. I started to cook dinner for my kids, and all the little kids around the camp come in, can I have a bite, can I have a bite? But they was hungry than people were. And I got my car fixed, and I was just getting ready to pull out when she come back and snapped my picture. I come to this town in 1945. I transferred from Whittier State to Modesto. And when this hospital opened up out here, I went to work there. And the first 8 years I lived in this town, I worked 16 hours out of 24, 8 and a half years, 7 days a week.
Are you comfortable now?
Yeah.